You guys ready? Good. I got a key for the open beta, Total War Arena. So I'm gonna show it off. And thanks to the devs for giving me that. And this wouldn't be this wouldn't happen without you guys, cause you guys made me popular on YouTube and they sent me a code. So yeah. And now I have to wait. So guys, if you're watching this later or if you're watching it now, don't forget to check out the link in the description. It's my Patreon page. You can donate to me there and you can play with me in my live streams. As long as you have the games that I'm gonna play with. So, yeah. Don't forget. And now I have to wait because I literally just started it up. I'm gonna react to a video real quick. While it's loading. But yeah, I had to delete our stuff just to play this, so yeah. Here it is.
Here. Since I've been in town, they can't seem to do enough for me. They gave me a big car to drive around, a big Rolls Royce. See, my wife says, "Let me drive that thing. I can stop it on a dime." She did. But the dime was in the little old man's pocket. She's driving, the guy stepped off the curb, and I says, "Give him the right of way." And she plows right into him. "What did you do that for?" "You told me to. I said, give him the right of way. I thought you said, get him right away." Well, we were out driving. Hey, I don't know who laid out these freeways in Canada. But you got to be proud of him over at the asylum, I'll tell you that. Well, you get on one of them things you want to get off, you better be in the right lane at the right time, make the right. It happened to me. But I didn't mind. I'd never been to Kansas City before anyhow. Anyhow, we're driving, see, and we go into this gas station. You know what I can't understand about a gas station? The cash box is out in the open, the office is out in the open, and they lock the restrooms. I got a joke for you. You better leave the hat out. Where's it at? Has he got it again? Yeah.
you've been in my geritol, ain't you? I got a joke for you. I was driving the other day, and to avoid an accident, I had to pull in front of a lady driver. She was very nice about the whole thing, said something about the beach. I didn't hear what it was. Why, you got a funny beach around here, huh? This dear little lady, she must have been nearsighted. She mistook me for a Spaniard. She called me Sebastian. I heard that. I got a joke for you. If you've heard this, don't stop me, because I'm dying to hear it again. Two highway patrolmen, they're driving, see? One of these officers turns to his buddy and he says, "You realize that we've been on duty all day, we haven't given out one ticket?" He says, "We nabbed the next car that goes by." Now, it's a big Cadillac. They tail this guy, but he stays in the right lane, uses the proper hand signals, the directional lights are perfect, he stays within the maximum speed. So one officer says to his buddy, "I've never seen anyone from Canada drive this carefully before. We ought to congratulate that guy." So they pull him over. He says, "Nothing wrong, sir, nothing wrong, just wanted to congratulate you. 35 years I've been on the highway patrol, I have never seen anyone from Canada drive so carefully." This guy says, "When you're crocked, you gotta be careful." I'd like to do for you now, as you get older in life, you sort of look back at things. I remember a lot of things. Like, I remember when I was a little boy, you'd stand on the roadside and something would whiz by you. It'd be some horse feeling his oats, you know. Now you stand on the freeway and something whizzes by you. It's some jackass with too much grass. I heard two Texans talking over in the hotel. And one of them said to the other, he says, "I like the way they stand, see?" You never know if their thumbs are cold or if they've got gas. He says, "Now that we're getting friendly with China, tell me, do you believe in Buddha?" He says, "I believe in what?" "Do you believe in Buddha?" "I don't know." "Buddha? Well, Buddha's been around a long time. I don't know if I believe in Buddha or not, but Buddha's all right, yeah. I like Buddha. I like Buddha for what the hell? I like margarine just as well." I play a lot of the colleges, and while I was at Muncie, Indiana, at Ball State University, the students got together and they made Clem Cadiddlehopper a doctor of foolology. So at this time, we would like to introduce you now to our friend, Clem Cadiddlehopper. Well, sir, it's nice to see you folks again. It's been a long time since I saw you last. I got married. I had a military wedding. Well, there were guns there, let's put it that way. My wife is a lovely lady. She's only 21. Of course, that's 150 for you and me. She's very superstitious. For instance, now she won't do housework any week that has Friday in it. Yes, since I saw you last, I haven't been doing much of anything. I never did do much of anything. I've been helping the Boy Scouts. I show them how to make them Boy Scout knots. Boy, I'm a whiz with that. Everything I see, boy, I tie a knot in it. They made me stop milking, you know. But I raise rabbits now. I raise rabbits. These are not ordinary rabbits. Some of these rabbits, they've never been outdoors. These are ingrown hairs. You better start the car. Boy, the way you reacted to that, I'm glad I didn't tell you the one I was going to tell you. But the little rabbit was going to have an operation, but he wouldn't take any anesthetic because he was an ether bunny. But you know, my rabbits are smart. My rabbits are smart. I make a mine. I shake a stick at them. I say, you mind me, and I shake this stick at them, you know. The other day I had a couple who wouldn't mind me at all. So I locked them up in a barn for a few days. I'll never do that again either. I opened that door, I had more rabbits I could shake a stick at. You can shut the motor off. Yeah, the other day, there's a couple of coyotes chased a couple of my rabbits into a haystack. And one rabbit turned to the other and he says, we're going to make a run for it or stay here and outnumber them. He said, we're going to make a run for it, you idiot. We're brothers. Tonight, I would like to recite to you, some poetry that I have written. And this poetry here is this poetry is set to the same cadence as Rudyard Kipling's poem Boots. You've all heard Boots? You've never heard Boots? Boots, boots, marching up and down again. Boots, boots. In the slush and in the rain, cannons and guns firing far beyond their range, and there's no silence in the night. Now you heard it. This poem is set to that same cadence, but this is instead of boots, this is called frogs. Frogs. Oh, by the way, I don't need glasses, but I reached the age where curiosity is greater than vanity. I just got these a few days ago. My optimist came up to me and he said, my eye doctor, the optimist. There's a guy one brick short of a load too, I'll tell you. He says to me, Clem, come in and get your eyes checked. Well, I don't like checked eyes. I like them brown like they are. I don't know what anybody would want with checked eyes. It's all right if you're a cab driver, I suppose, but I wouldn't care for them myself. This poem is called A Frog, and it's set to the same cadence here. I will, I've heard it myself. I don't care for it. I don't mind reading for you, but I ain't gonna suffer, I'll tell you that. This is set to that same cadence. Say, Maestro. Is he all rehearsed now? Okay. Frogs, 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 they are everywhere. Frogs, frogs, frogs croaking fill the air. Louder, louder, louder is their blasting blare, and there's no silence in the night. Well, you knew I wasn't Richard Burton when I came out here. Frogs. Frogs. Croaks heard 3 miles away, 5, 6, 7 beyond that, they say, frogs. Frog multiplying more each day, and there's no silence in the night. Now there's some undertone chittering going on out there. Now either you hush up or I'll clear the hall. And about 2 more verses ought to do it. Frogs. Frogs. Don't get me to laugh and you'll never get out of here.
tried to seek them out. Frogs hiding all about. Grab their throats and wring them out, because there is no silence in the night. Frogs, they're good as only bad. Flirting on their lily pads. Mom says no, but you know, Dad, there's no silence in the night. Frogs, don't you know the strain? Frogs, please refrain and listen. There they go again! Seems that each day, new talent.
Good, I'm still recording. Otherwise, that would have been for a complete waste. Let's hope. Nope, it's not even done. But hey, it's halfway, so. I'm gonna have you guys listen to some music. I need to get something to eat real quick. Because I have not had breakfast yet. So, I think I might have you guys listen to one of my playlists, hopefully. Hopefully this video won't get copyright striked.
I am more than a student. I am a work in progress. I am one.
I'm gonna go get something to eat real quick.
Santa Claus, huh? Ooh, I'm really scared. So you're the one everybody's talking about. You're joking. I can't believe my eyes. You're joking me. You gotta be. This can't be the right guy. He's ancient. He's ugly. I don't know which is worse. I might just split a seam now if I laugh at first. Close at hand. You touch now, cause I'm the boogeyman. And if you're shaking, there's something that this may be the last time you hear the boogie song. Of snake spider stew, and that would make it nice. A roly poly Santa Claus, Dad, a little spy. Release me now, or you must face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
I can't believe my ears. Would someone shut this up? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny, I'm laughing.
You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm
going to
do the best I can.
yes, I'm the boogeyman. And if you aren't shaking, there's something very wrong. Cause this may be the last time you hear the boogie song. Much to do, I might just cook a special batch of snake and spider stew. And don't you know the one thing that would make it work so nice? A roly-poly Santa Claus to add a little spice.
Whoa.
Whoa. Oh.
Whoa.
Yeah, I'm the Oogie Boogie Man.
Release me now, or you must face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
Ah, you're joking! You're joking! I can't believe my ears! Would someone shut this fella up? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny! I'm laughing! You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm
going to
do the best I can. More fun, I must confess, with lives on the line. Not mine, of course, but yours, oh boy. Now let it be just fine.
Release me fast, or you will have to answer for this heinous act.
Oh, brother, you're something. You put me in a spin. You aren't comprehending the position that you're in. It's hopeless. You're finished. You haven't got a prayer. Cause I'm Mr. Oogie Boogie, and you ain't going. Claws, huh? Ooh, I'm really scared. So you're the one everybody's talking about. You're joking. You're joking. I can't believe my eyes. You're joking me. You gotta be. This can't be the right guy. He's ancient. He's ugly. I don't know which is worse. I might just split a seam now if I don't die laughing first. Mr. Oogie Boogie says there's trouble close at hand. You better pay attention now, cause I'm the boogeyman. And if you aren't shaking, there's something very wrong. Cause this may be the last time you hear the boogie song.
And don't you know the one thing that would make it work so nice? A roly-poly Santa Claus dad, a little spy.
Face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
Ah, you're joking! You're joking! I can't believe my ears! Would someone shot this fella? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny! I'm laughing! You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm
going to
do the best I can. Just split a seam now if I don't die laughing first. Mr. Oogie Boogie says there's trouble close at hand. You better pay attention now, cause I'm the boogeyman. And if you aren't shaking, there's something very wrong, cause this may be the last time you hear the boogie song. Much to do, I might just cook a special batch of snake and spider stew. And don't you know the one thing that would make it work so nice? A roly-poly Santa Claus dad, a little spy.
Face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
Ah, you're joking! You're joking! I can't believe my ears! Would someone shot this fella? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny! I'm laughing! You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm
going to
do the best I can. More fun, I must. special batch of snake and spider stew. And don't you know the one thing that would make it work so nice? A roly-poly Santa Claus to add a little spice.
Face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
Ah, you're joking! You're joking! I can't believe my ears! Would someone shut this fella up? I'm drowning in my tears. It's funny! I'm laughing! You really are too much. And now, with your permission, I'm going to do my stuff.
Well, what are you going to do?
I'm
going to
do the best I can. Just split a seam now if I don't die laughing first. Mr. Oogie Boogie says there's trouble close at hand. You better pay attention now, cause I'm the boogeyman. And if you aren't shaking, there's something very wrong, cause this may be the last time you hear the boogie song. Much to do. I might just cook a special batch of snake and spider stew. And don't you know the one thing that would make it work so nice? A roly-poly Santa Claus to add a little spice. I'm the Oogie Boogie Man.
Release me now, or you must face the dire consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses.
Ah, you're joking! You're joking! I can't believe my ears! Would someone shut this fella up? I'm drowning!
Sorry that you couldn't listen to music for that long. But now it is time to play Warhammer. Well, not Warhammer, Total War Arena. I am not going to show you my thing, so I'm going to do this. And I'm back. I'm really excited for this. I've been waiting all week to play this because I wanted to do a live stream about it. I'm really excited. Where's the game running though? This might be a bug. Never mind. Ooh, I've been waiting for this. Yes. I have to play the tutorial though, because I haven't played this before. I had Nutella on bread for breakfast, by the way. Breakfast! again, guys, don't forget to check the link in the description. It's my Patreon page. You can buy some packs, and you can join me in my live streams by playing with me. And if you buy one of the two packs, or if you buy both packs, then you have access to the Discord server. One pack is normal ranks, and the other pack is admins. The admins pack is admins for the Discord server, and the I think it's the Rose Army pack is the regular ranks. There we go.
Welcome to Total War Arena. These are the proving grounds where you will learn the basics of the game.
Oh,
on
man,
arena's
lightning.
Endless battlefields, you and your allies will strive for honor and glory, and eventually rise as legends. There are three ways to
the
secure
barbarians
victory
have
in
established
battle.
A base
destroy
on the capital
the enemy
hill.
Army. Join your
capture
Roman
their base,
allies and capture
or survive
it
with your soldiers
it.
Alive when the battle timer runs out.
In Total War Arena, you command a squad of three units, each containing up to 100 soldiers. Your commander leads the first unit and boosts the strength of your entire squad as long as he or she lives. Let's survey the battlefield. The enemy's base is just up the road. Move your camera there to check on your allies' progress. Strange. Things have gone quiet. Rotate your camera around so you can see your commander and squad. Now head back to your squad's location.
I'm so excited.
To reach the base, you will need to follow the main road. Start by selecting the unit with your commander. Hover over the lead unit and left click on it with your mouse.
Swordsman!
This
Ooh.
Unit is now under your command. Move
I
to
really
the marked location
I really
by right clicking on the ground.
Spartans.
Nice work. More than one unit can be selected at a time. Do this now by holding down left click and dragging a box around your entire squad. Now get your
I'm
squad moving by right-clicking on the
no,
location
this is
mark.
Athenians, I think it is.
Quickly!
Handsomely, gents, handsomely. That means slowly, by the way. Well, it did back like in the 1600s or 1500s.
Your
I
squad
can't
has
remember.
Tightened ranks. While this is useful to squeeze through narrow lanes, you will usually want them to march in formation. When you issue a move order, hold down right click and rotate the cursor to perfectly position your units. Try it now. Order your squad back in formation.
Right click and then go right. I'm doing that.
Swordsman!
Oh, cool.
Double time!
The fog of war hangs over parts of the battlefield where you and your allies are not positioned, hiding enemy movement. Some units can see farther than others, and certain terrain can obscure their line of sight.
Death has come for the enemy commander!
Arminius has taken advantage of the natural cover of the forest, but his squad's health is low. Right-click on his units to move forward and attack. Send them to Elysium.
quickly! Enemies of Germania!
Arminius luckily, snuck his third Roman pedetes come equipped you. With pilar that
archers
they can
can attack from range.
Select one of your units to
and
left click
throw pilar on your action bar.
Then target the enemy and left click on it with your mouse. Throw pilar is a targeted ability unique to swordsmen. All units have abilities of one kind or another.
How do I get him to throw? What letter is that? I can't see.
Well done. Let's try
Versin
a flanking
Getarix
maneuver.
Is blocking the pass with strong defenders.
Your ally approaches, but he needs your help. Move your units forward and attack from behind. Together you and Caesar will flank the enemy's soldiers and break their morale.
Oh, it's Caesar's army, so it'd be Roman, I think.
Rally to me! Break them! Focus your fire!
Excellent. See how the unit's morale wavers and breaks? You have them at your mercy. Soldiers
flanking enemies is the surest way to
break their morale. Represents their lifeblood, while morale represents belief. Belief in oneself and in one's commander and the will to fight on. When morale breaks, the soldiers rout, scattering and retreating from battle. Good. Now only one task remains.
Yeah.
Take the enemy base. To capture a base, your team must occupy it uncontested by standing within its perimeter. Go there now. Caesar has entered the base, but cannot capture it while taking damage. Those archers are contesting him. Help your ally. Chase out the enemy and win this battle.
Oh, that would make sense since they're Roman, because they go, whew. But don't the Athenians do as well? Interesting.
Yes, you've stopped them from firing. The base is being captured. You have won your first battle. Well fought.
I think that's a good place to leave off and leave you guys in a cliffhanger. And yeah, that was fun, like a lot of fun. So tune into the next one as well. And don't forget to check out my Patreon, the link will be in the description below. And don't forget to buy one of the packs so that way you can join me. I have a couple keys for people who join me before the open beta is closed for me. So, yeah. See ya later. Bye.
If you're only hungry for a slice of pie, why buy the whole pie? And if you don't...
Stand up like a soldier, baby. Yeah, I know you've been...